Hi everyone, hope you're good. Hope your families are good. There's a great fight coming up. Really, really good fight. I'm looking forward to it next weekend, I believe it is, 24th of April, between Denzel Bentley and Felix Cash for the British and Commonwealth middleweight titles. I've been looking forward to this one for a while. I mean, if you're interested in this, you're probably a bit more of a hardcore fan because it's kind of two fighters who, you know, you need to know your boxing really to know a bit about this fight, don't you, I suppose. And yeah, it's got all the makings of being a really genuinely exciting and interesting fight. It's two fighters who are at a similar stage of their careers. I think Denzel's 14-0 and Felix is 13-0. It's something like that anyway. Both got good knockout percentages, with Denzel Bentley's being slightly higher, 12 stoppages in his 14 wins. I'd say Felix Cash has probably got the more, let's say, big fight experience in terms of just who he's boxed. Just for the likes of people like Wellborn, people like Jack Cullen, that was a good show. That was at the Manchester Arena. I was at that one. Well, Denzel Bentley's been getting better with every performance, hasn't he? I mean, this is all the makings and ingredients. It's really good. It's Matchroom versus Queensbury as well, which I know. Well, that adds a bit of excitement for me anyway. I do like that angle a bit as well. They should do a show, shouldn't they? Like Matchroom versus Queensbury, that'd be good. But yeah. So, what are the dynamics of this fight? I mean, Denzel Bentley is the British champion. He won that off in a bout for the vacant title against Mark Heffron in their rematch. Their first fight was really close. Some people had Mark winning, some people had Denzel winning, some people had it a draw. It was a draw in the end on the cards. But in the rematch, he looked a different person. He, and that impressed me because it looked like, you know, he's the type of guy who really took that draw, that blemish on the record, seriously. Worked on a few things, come back, and it's just his focus. I mean, obviously Mark sustained that horrendous injury, and I spoke to Mark a couple of days after that fight, and that eye was terrible, horrendous, and you can't really go on with an injury like that. Nonetheless, Denzel Bentley's attitude for that fight, the way he shaped up, the way he, you know, just the way he came in, made me think this guy's a serious fighter. And you know, at first when I saw this matchup, you think to yourself, well, Cash has had a little bit more, like I say, experience against top level opponents, but I think Bentley's confidence and the momentum he's on does equalize that a little bit as well. Looking at Cash, he's a great mover, he's a natural boxer, he's a hard hitter as well. He's got a good ring IQ, he comes in ridiculously unbelievable shape, he's always shredded. And these title fights, these British title fights and Commonwealth title fights, always produce a good fight because you generally get people that are at that level who have earned it by beating some good names in like the Jack Cullens. I mean, that fight with Felix Cass with Jack Cullen, that was a great fight. I was there ringside for that fight and I thoroughly enjoyed it. It just showed that Felix Cass has got more to his game. He's not just an on-top fighter. He can take shots. When the heat is turned up a bit, he can rise to the occasion because Jack Cullen is no slouch. He's a top fighter. So is Mark Heffron as well. You know, that's why I like these sort of fights, these domestic tear-ups, because really, they're very well matched. And this one, I think, is going slightly under the radar, and it, you know, you should tune into this fight because it's going to be top. People keep asking me who do I think is going to win, and I'm finding it really difficult to call a winner on this. I think before the two Heffron fights would have gone with Felix Cash, now I think it's just level, it's just dead even. I don't know. Who do you guys think is going to win this one? And yeah, going back to Bentley, Bentley looks quite versatile himself, doesn't he? He can bang. He's got a good straight right hand. He's good jab. It varies it well. Again, he's quite elusive himself. He can take a shot because he took a good left hook off Mark Heffron in their first fight. And, you know, Mark can really bang and he took that shot. It's just a good fight. You know, these are the sort of fights that we should be getting behind. You know, these all British domestic tear-ups. I mean, Cash has had, you know, what one win that Cash had that went under the radar a little bit, it doesn't get as much credit for, is the Stephen Daniel win. Stephen Daniel's a really good fighter. I've seen him train a lot when he was training in Manchester. And, you know, it's all to play for. I wish them both the best because, you know, we've got two very prestigious titles on the line there, the British and the Commonwealth. And the winner really sets themselves up for a run into the next level, European level, and who knows, further beyond. I mean, it's a tough weight division, middleweight, but that fight, I just cannot wait for it. On another note, I'm delighted to see amateur gyms open again. Big shout out to all the amateur coaches out there who do such a top job. The lifeblood of the sports, and the grassroots level is just such an important level in the game. And also delighted to hear that some small hall shows are being announced, and which again is going to give people who've been waiting in the wings a chance to get back out there and start earning some money and start focusing back on their boxing career. So all the best to everybody, and I hope you guys are doing well, whatever you're up to.